Hello everyone, my name is Devin Krause, and for the past 4 years, I've been trying to become an animator. If you're watching this video expecting a tutorial, then you're in the wrong place. But that doesn't mean you won't find something you might be looking for. This isn't a how-to series or just a bunch of random tutorials, although I might do some tutorials in a few weeks once I've had a little bit of practice. No, this is more of a documentation of my journey to becoming an animator. I will, however, be linking any and all books, online courses, tutorials, animations, animators, and anything else that I use in these videos. So with that said, welcome to An Animator in the Making. So it turns out I didn't have the King Foley rig, so that took up a large chunk of this week. But I did actually get around to making the dance animation, which you will see actually a little later in the video. It's nothing too impressive, but I'll touch on that when we get to it. So what I did was rigged his model, and once I was done, I realized that his bone structure was 8 different bone structures. Which, I'm going to research how to do this because it'll just be easier animating down the line. I need to convert those 8 down into one file, so when I manipulate one, it manipulates the others in a similar fashion. I know it's possible because I've done it before, I just cannot remember for the life of me how. So I will be trying to learn how to do that and convert some of the files of like the king, the queen, and eventually in the future when I make more, I'm gonna just start making them all like that. I know it has something to do with making the bone layer on top and then the switch layer, but I cannot remember again how to do it. Beyond that, they actually work pretty well. There's not a lot of deforming, I didn't have to make any smart bones for them since I made most of their limbs out of just line art, so they look fantastic when animated. There are a few problems with the king, such as I touched on this in my last video, where when he kind of bends his arm too far, it stretches out of the armor. But again, I do like that feature on this version of him, because it makes it feel a little more realistic. The armor is constraining to him, it limits his movement. Another thing I noticed about this kind of model was I have to remember when I'm moving the layer itself and then just moving the entire file. Because if I do one or the other, I have to stick with that and not do them separately. Otherwise, as you'll kind of notice in the dance animation, some characters are just drifting. That's when I moved the entire file and not the single bone structure file, which I should have just moved the entire file itself, because then I would have been moving all 8 models and not having him jump around as much. So once I kind of get this animatic done, because I'm just doing this for practice again, I'll probably go back and work on getting all the models into one file and working with them there. I got it about a third of the way done. I definitely would have gotten a lot more done if I wouldn't have fooled around with the King model so much, but I had to have that done so I could actually animate anything. So again, I'm going to finish up working. I'm doing this on every 24 frames, by the way. You probably would want to know that. Every 24 frames, I animate whatever that key is, and then go to the next 24 frames. So it's not like I'm animating in those 24 frames like anything else other movement-wise. I'm just trying to get like a rough animation of all the important shots. It started with me like animating every 12 frames, but that was just taking way too much time. So about 5-6 seconds into the video, I switch over to 24 frames and just start animating from there. Once I started animating like that, yeah, it made it feel a little slower, but again, it's not supposed to be fluid animation. But it does still look pretty good for what I was going for. I do hope to have like a very good looking, kind of smooth dance animation when it's done. I also am going to probably make a very simple background for it. I don't know what that's going to look like, and I'm not even going to fool with it until I got it done. I also got to make the more dynamic camera shots, because if you're watching the video in the top left corner, you'll notice that they do a lot of zoom-in shots on kind of their upper body, then they'll zoom back out to their legs. So I've got to do a lot more shots like that. Those will actually be a lot easier, believe it or not. Because Moho actually comes with a way to just move the camera. I think every software comes with that, honestly. But I'm just going to focus on making their regular dance and then focus on the camera at the very end when I'm in the final tuning. One weird thing that happened was when rendering it, it smashed together some of my information tabs at the top right-hand side of the screen. It was supposed to tell you, like, what frames I animated on those days, like how many in total. For some reason, I just smashed them into one. I did put them back in the video, so you wouldn't think, oh, he didn't animate a lot on day one or two, so he just wanted to hide that. No, no, I genuinely put it back in, because I want you to see what I was working on. It also, for some reason, drops in quality when I'm working with it, just animating in general. I don't know why it drops so much in quality, because normally it's fine. The only thing I can figure is the video is taking up a lot of data in the top left-hand corner of the screen, so it's just putting all the rendering power into that video instead of the rest of the animation until it's fully rendered. Don't know why it smashes it together though. When I render it out as an image, they're fine, and I can render it out on any frame and they look exactly the same. But the minute I go to video format, it just smushes those two together only. You'll see it later at the end of the video when I actually show the animation. If you're wondering what the music is from the video, I don't know what the song is. It just came standard with the video I'm using as an example. You can look up the video if you want. It's just some kind of, I guess, tutorial. I'm not exactly sure what it is. I just kind of looked up waltz dance and it was one of the first things that popped up. One thing that kind of surprised me was how much work goes into each shot. One thing that fascinates me about this kind of video that I used is how much detail goes into each shot. Each shot has kind of a purpose to it. Not only do they keep the two dancers kind of center screen the whole time, but even when moving around the room, the camera motion just feels so organic and natural. It's not like shaking around or anything like that. Yeah, I know this was done by professionals and everything, but it just looks amazing. The fact that you kind of don't notice there's camera movement, you just notice the two dancers and see them kind of moving, is the most amazing part of this. And that's kind of something I want to capture eventually. Now, what it will be in the final animation when I get to that point will be just mostly the background moving, and the characters will just stay in their kind of standard form. I don't know what that will look like. I don't know if I'll make that in Blender and make an actual 3D background and render it out in that, and then put the 2D animation inside it, which is something that I've seen other people use before. It's actually a pretty effective method, apparently. I just don't know how to use Blender very well, and I don't know how to put... Well, let me rephrase. I do know how to put 2D animations into Blender. I just don't know if I could make it look good. I'd have to practice a lot more with Blender's cameras. I honestly probably will wind up doing that, because I do want to learn how to use Blender as well. And the whole point of doing this is to teach myself how to use stuff. So, I'll probably do that, see how it looks, and render out a good 1-2 minute animation, I'm not exactly sure how long the video is, of them dancing. And then, hopefully, if I can get that done in a reasonable amount of time, I can start working on other things. I would love to start working on animal movement next. Like, maybe a horse, because I do want to do a horseman. And I've done a horse animation before. It doesn't look super great, I'm just gonna tell you that. And I'd love to improve on that. But I'm just gonna go at this one step at a time, just first starting with the human movement, and then I'm gonna start working with facial expressions, because I kinda wanna get these characters, I don't know if they're gonna talk or not, because I've always thought animations where characters didn't talk and they elicited emotions other ways were kind of interesting. But at the same time, I'm not opposed to them talking. So I'm gonna see what I can capture with facial expression-wise, because with them having no mouths, that makes it a little hard to know how they're feeling. So a lot of their emotion will be coming from their eyes, and also body motion. But a lot of their, like, kind of more subtle emotions, like disgust maybe, or joy, like just slight joy, it would come from their eyes. So that's another thing I'm going to start working on to see if I can capture that kind of emotion of each frame. I mean, I expected it to be a lot of work, and I knew there was going to be a lot of detail that I definitely wasn't seeing, but it does shock me how much work that goes into a cartoon, just even as simple as this. I don't have any background yet, and it's just very, like, dry, choppy animation I spent about 2 days on just to get about a minute's worth of footage. Sure, I've not put all my time into it. Like, if I would have put a full, like, 2 8-hour days into this, it definitely would look a lot better. Heck, it'd probably be a lot closer to done. But it shocks me at how much, like, that I didn't realize detail-wise goes into cartoons like this. Yeah, it's definitely gonna be a challenge, and it's not put me off in any way. but I'm definitely excited to see like what else is coming and to improve my skill, because I know the more I do this, the faster I'll get at it. So until next week, I hope to have this a lot more fluid by then, and hopefully I'll have all the models made better so I'm not doing these mistakes that you'll see in the animation. Episode, please like and subscribe. If you want to know when I upload my next video, then don't forget to turn on notifications. And if you know someone who you think would enjoy this video, then please share it with them. Also, we have a Reddit page now, so please come ruin it with us.